Hello, this is Hirodov YouTube channel. In this video I will unbox and test for you HDMI video capture with video HDMI out except for video in. This device looks very similar to the other device that I already unboxed for you. This HDMI video capture, but this one has HDMI out as well. You see application diagram here. You can go to computer and separate screen, something which the much more expensive Decoding 4K Extreme already has as well. The output features are written here. Let's take this out. And application for streaming, video conferencing, presentations and so on. Support HDMI loop out, support input max resolution 4K. Output max resolution is 1080p. So slightly less features, but it's not as expensive as the Decoding 12G Extreme 4K. So let's open and see what's inside. Very easy to open. Basic packaging. And unlike on the cheaper version, here is Type-C to USB cable. Why do I need this? Maybe it's put inside by mistake. And as with the other card, HDMI video capture. So instead of different manual, it's the same as the other card, but anyway the device is different. 4K Ultra HD in capital letters, HDMI out, HDMI in, video capture with loop out. So that's the difference with this one. It's with loop out, and I got this cable for free for some reason unknown to me. Anyway, it's 3.0 interface USB. What's this here? Now I understand. Unlike the other device, this one, which doesn't need external power, this one needs power. That's why this cable. Now I understand. Okay, so it needs additional power supply. So maybe I prefer the other version, which doesn't need power supply and just plugs in. Okay, let's go test it on my hardware and software combination, the PC compatible computer. And here is my software and hardware combination, IBM PC compatible computer, Mr. Hardware connected through USB 3. Also I'm having HDMI out. Not sure if it will be captured by the Decoding with these frame rates, but anyway, let's test. Insert the power. Nothing happens. No sign if it's working. Let's try to add it in OBS. Add video capture device USB video. And it works immediately. Mister is working. You see, let's try to remove the power supply. And it works without power supply. So this power supply maybe is for the HDMI out. For now, let's try it with the game commando. C-O-M-A-N-D-O. And start recording. And it works! Switching screen mode resolutions. For the sound, right now it's not configured to have sound. You can add it by two, like in the other device, two ways. One is here, output desktop audio, custom audio device. But this one is giving me lag. So I don't use this. Remove it and add it separately on the audio input capture in OBS. Digital audio interface. And now it works. Here, monitor and output. And now, no lag. I think there is still lag, so maybe the other device. Works better. But here is something very special about this device. Thanks to it, I can use my direct link. You see? Everything goes through the HDMI out. And I think no lag, or not sure. So I can use the link again to capture the mister. And what I found out is that the power is not needed at all. You see, it's self-powered. Not sure why this power is. Maybe for the out. Oops, pressed the power button by mistake. For the output out without capturing to the machine. You see, if I remove the power out, it's off. But when I power it, I can use it without its frame grabbing capture options, just for HDMI out. So it's converting the signal to appropriate use for my decklink, which is still nice. So I have decklink converter, something like. So I still use my headphones now, which is nice. And here is another test case, this time with time surveilled device. I will measure the lag between the two different capture methods through the decklink with HDMI out and through the USB capture. So let's out test both ways at video capture device USB video, and here is the time swelled. Now it's through the USB. Make this full screen and test the lag. Lag in milliseconds. Okay, average lag 100. This is through the USB capture. You see around 100. Let's test now the other method through the decklink. Turn off this tool. Start recording. Turn off. And use decklink. Again, full screen. Current 50. So it's half the lag. Average 63. Let's go back to the other method. Video capture. And try again because it's strange. USB device is giving twice as much lag, which is very strange. You see 135. Let's go back to the decklink. You see half the lag. Let's test. This is now the decklink. Let's try different resolution. 480E. So it needs some time for update. Going back to video capture device. Almost twice as much lag. You see, with the decrink it's half the lag. And here is another test case. This time it's Apple V4 connected to the frame grabber. And it works with the video capture device, but unfortunately it doesn't work with the Blackmagic decrink frame grabbing. So, win-lose situation. Anyway, let's record this as well at another audio input capture digital audio interface, set it to monitor and start some demo. It works. Let's see if the decrink is working. Unfortunately not. Neither sound, neither audio. Thanks for watching my video. See you in my next videos.